I've got a spin. I've got a spin for episode 107. And here's how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna ask myself a question. Hey Gary, great show, totally obsessed. My favorite thing now, ahead of Game of Thrones. Here's a question for you. If you had a business or a blog or a personal brand or a book, how would you get more people to you know about you and to buy that? To like, how would you get results? I guess at the end of the day, Gary, I'm asking you, how would you get results? Thanks, love the show. Gary, great question. Looking great, by the way. You know, one of the things I haven't talked about in the show a lot, I've talked about it a little bit, and I saw people get value from it in that local small business biz dev thing, is the gross underestimation of distribution in a JV, joint venture environment. There are so many of you on this show with businesses that have locked so heavily into social media, because that's how you view me, as the way to get distribution. You have left some of the greatest opportunities on the table, including if you are not hitting up the top 100 blogs in your space, if you're selling cupcakes and you literally aren't spending the time to figure out what the top 100 cupcake content sites are on the internet, and then sending an email and saying, hey, I'm India from India's Cupcake Shop. I love reading your site, Cupcake Daily. Oh, this is me typing the email. I love reading your site, Cupcake Daily. I'm very passionate. Here's my site. Here's my Instagram. I would love to write for you once a week on new sprinkles concepts or on decorations that matter. Like, I will give you my labor for free, and what you'll give me is distribution and awareness. If you don't realize that, you know, it's like Kendrick Lamar. Did anybody pay attention to what Kendrick Lamar did? If you don't know who Kendrick Lamar is, he's a rapper, an artist, and he went on to a lot of other albums as he was starting to get a little fame. He leveraged that to get on, and he came in trying to kill it. On, like, he basically went on everybody's track, and he tried to be so much better than the person whose song it was that everybody was listening and be like, oh shit, that guy's dope. Like, I'm gonna check him out. That's what India, the cupcake lady, wants to do on Cupcake Daily. Oh crap, that was such a good thought. Let me follow that. And so, in the earliest days of me building my brand, I went on wine blogs and wrote blog posts to contribute. And because I had the chops, you know, Kendrick spits incredible lyrics, India writes about incredible toppings, and I talked about incredible things about wine that people hadn't thought about. That gave me the ammo for my work to have a positive ROI. The truth is, a lot of you don't want to put in the work because the output of your content in video form, in audio form, in written form, isn't good enough. You just aren't good enough. What you're selling, they're not buying. And the quickest way to find out is to actually go on a road show, put in the 40 hours a day to get yourself into places where you, why can't you email all 500 people on YouTube that have some level of audience and ask them to be interviewed on our show or to be part of it? I mean, why can't you? Why can't you ask? Why can't you ask? Why can't you ask? That, my friend Gary, is what you need to do. If you've got something to sell, you need to go and knock on doors. Right? You know, you gotta know how to build them and walk through them. You gotta knock on doors and you gotta ask, like, can I guest contribute to your world? Can I write a blog post? Can I just show up and, like, how do I bring value to what you need? Because all these people that have homes, that have audiences, they need more content to feed them. Content costs money. So people coming in and contributing, it's the ultimate kind of leverage deal. You come and you write for me for free because I need it, because I need to keep feeding the kids I have in the room, and you need kids for what you're gonna do. And that is something that 99.99999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 audiences to be discovered. Putting out a picture on Instagram and holding your breath and hoping somebody's gonna see it because you used a fucking hashtag isn't enough. Go out and take it. And that, my friend Gary, is what you should do if you want something to happen.